I'm gonna kill somebody.
Why?
Because you're a pain in my ass.
Me?
You and Jorge both. It's crazy. Can I explain what the fuck was just going on here? I just finished Doped Up, and we were doing our Patreon episode, and I thought we were gonna have to move in here, but then Blind Mike was like, actually, I can't start the show yet. I'm editing a video. It might be a little while, and I went, all right, cool. We'll just do it in B so that we're not interrupting High Society Radio. And then an hour passed, seemingly. Half an hour to an hour passed. I was talking to Dylan about the show, but I went to Mike. I said, all right, let me know when you're done, and we can start our show. And then I hear your mic on. Don't even try it. And then I went, first I said to Harrington, I was like, where's Mike? And he goes, I don't know. I think he's touching himself. And I went, what? He goes, he's gone. I don't know where he is. And so Dylan and I finish up our fucking conversation. I go, I guess I should probably fucking find my co-host, huh? And I go into the other side, and I hear Dylan and Jorge up to no good, is what I hear. I hear them up to
Mike,
no good.
Not Dylan.
Oop. I hear Jorge and Mike up to no good. Dylan's gone. And then they go, I turn the corner, and they go, no, 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 you can't see what we're fucking doing. No, 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 no. I almost fucking fought Jorge over there. I was trying to get there. He's like, don't fucking make me touch you. Get back. And I'll fucking kill you right now. What are you hiding? What are you hiding? I hate it. Whatever's going on, I fucking hate it. It's so hot in here.
It was Mike's bit, all right?
Am I going to know what the bit is?
I don't know.
I hear you. You're fine.
Jorge, what is happening?
Jorge, what is happening?
I don't know.
Are we doing this or not?
What's the bit?
This
is why you're an engineer, Jorge.
No, Jorge, don't. No.
You might
salvage this.
You might get into the bit later.
Might?
Yeah, I don't know if he still wants to do it.
You have to. We have to.
No, it's kind of funny if we don't now.
I'm going to kill myself if we don't.
Why is this?
That's the best outcome.
If this is my last episode, you'll know why.
Let's lean into it, dude.
Let's just get right into
it. I'm going to lean the fuck into this bit.
Is this us saying let's get right into it?
Would you be able to prep it by chance?
I don't give a shit.
Let's just jump right into it.
All right, give me like 43 seconds.
Okay, turn your mic off.
Wait, what?
Hi, welcome to GaS Digital Now, the GaS Digital wrap-up show. I'm engineer Natalie, that's Blind Mike, and I am fucking amped. I've had a great week, but we're not talking about this week, are we? We're talking about last week, because that's what we do here.
We might have to talk a little bit about this week.
I mean, happy New Year. How was your New Year's? What can you get into on the show?
Oh,
actually, get into all of it, and then you can choose to cut out what is not beyond the statute of limitations of you being able to talk about. I don't know what the fuck you got into.
Drugs, probably. Yeah, it turns out I should have probably made plans in advance. So
Mike all week was like, you guys got doing anything for New Year's? I didn't know if I was at the time. So what did you do New Year's Eve? You were in Pennsylvania?
Yeah, my buddies, I did go to Philly, and I just remember my friends from college always talk about this one bar they used to bartend at that I never actually had been to, even though they'd always talked about it. So I was like, let me just check this out, see what's going on.
Yeah.
Because, it just sounded fun, and so I went there just dolo, and was drinking, had a good time, but...
Ellipses, you're not going to get into how fun it was.
No, here, all right, so it starts off, and I get in there, I get a drink or whatever, and I'm walking, like, around.
Were they bartending actively?
What's that?
Like, they were currently bartending,
they were
not. Just a fan of this bar.
They probably quit and are working actual jobs now, but when they were in college, they were bartending there. I was like, I hate bars with covers.
Yeah, me too.
So let me just go to this one.
Yeah.
And
fuck that. Especially if it's, you know,
yeah,
not a live,
said.
You know, not like live performance or anything.
Pillow wind.
Only for Pillow End. Well, yeah, if there's a band, that's different. But, like, if there's a cover just to go in and pay money to drink, like, that's crazy.
Yeah. But what's crazy was I went upstairs, and I just hear this dude, and he's like, "Hey, I know you." I'm like, "Oh, no, not again."
Who is it?
Legion of Skag Strikes Again. I did not know this person.
Not at all.
But apparently he remembered me from, I guess, my childhood when I lived in Allentown.
That's funny.
And it took me a minute because...
Did you eventually remember him?
No.
That's hilarious.
And
I
couldn't tell if he was fucking with me at first. Because I like walked in there and I was like, "Dude, what? You're fucking with me, right?" And they're like, "No, he's not fucking. He's not like this. He doesn't..." I'm like, "Dude, you have to be."
Yeah.
I mean, maybe it's just...
They knew your name, though. Did
no,
they?
No, they didn't.
Oh.
But he was like, "I know you from Allentown. We went to camp together." I was like, "Okay."
Did you go to this camp?
I don't know. He didn't even... I don't know what the fuck.
So did you go to camp?
Probably.
Jesus Christ. You don't remember if you went to camp or not?
I've moved around so much.
Oh, that's crazy. I remember if I've gone to camp.
It was probably a camp, but... I mean, he
could have
just
know this
been
dude. This dude doesn't know you. He's making it up, dude.
Maybe.
He heard someone say Allentown and went, "I'm gonna
I
fuck
didn't
with this
say
guy."
Anything.
Oh, well then.
That's what makes it weird.
That is what
no
makes it
one
weird.
Knew.
Like, he knew
Allentown.
Where you were from, but like not. That's weird.
And then I don't know.
Did you exchange Instagram with him or anything?
No, I was actually cool with his friends because then he pretended to kiss me. I was like, "Yo, chill."
Chill. You're like, "No, I will only kiss people."
He was
willingly,
very drunk,
and I am not willing to kiss
you
right now.
Yeah, he was very drunk.
Yeah.
And I'm
oh,
not,
sounds like it.
Not
obviously.
Gay. Promise.
Gay Mike? Gay boy Mike? Not gay.
No. You said also you're doing a dry January. What's
I'm doing
up with
an
this?
Unofficial dry January. You know, I'm not drinking. If there's some sort of grand situation that presents itself, maybe I'll drink, but it's
like,
been...
Like, you know, high society radio.
No. Not like that. I just mean, like, if someone takes me out for drinks and goes, "I'll buy you a drink," yeah, maybe I'll have a drink. But, like, I went a little hard this weekend. I told you about it.
Let's hear about
it. We went to a friend's party in around Rutgers. Went too hard too early.
Finally.
And then as I was, you know, an hour later when I was like, "I'm drunk, I should chill," people kept handing me drinks. And then I fell asleep on the couch. And I woke up at 7:30 to my girlfriend and my friend watching YouTube compilations. 7:30 a.m. Stayed up. Helped clean, because you know you love to make fun of me because I always clean at parties. But this was like the next day and the host, who's my friend, is sober, so I'm like, it would be really shitty to leave this person with like bottles and cans everywhere. So
yeah,
I'll straighten out. And then we went home. Happy New Year.
All right, so let's go with this then. I gave you a little bit of homework. I was really busy earlier this week.
Yeah.
And so I was like, I want to do a classic clip segment on the show, but I didn't have time to search through episodes and find specific clips. So I'm like, "Hey, Nat, your Monday is probably free. Why don't you just watch this episode and come in with some notes? I'll write some notes of my own and let's just discuss it." So I asked
So I watched it today.
To you to watch the thing is number 132 with Dave Landau and Corinne Fisher. This is a sleeper classic. Not a lot of people remember this one as being a classic just because, you know, they had bigger guests on.
Sure.
But
Nothing crazy happened. It was just like a overall great episode of The Thing Is.
There wasn't a bad story, and that's why I was like, these are some of my favorite stories. I always love to hear Dave Landau's drinking day stories.
Yeah.
So that's why. I don't know what you thought about him, but I'd like to hear it. Did you have any notes that you wrote down or mental notes you remember?
Mental notes about his stories?
Just episode in general. You said you had some things.
I had some things. I watched this. I very rarely watch old episodes. And I noted some things that I think we should bring back and noted some things that I'm glad we left in the past.
You also had a problem with the word empath.
What's that was the empath? Sound I fucking made when they started talking about empaths at the beginning of this episode.
What's your beef?
I put it on in the lounge. Sorry to move my hand into your shot. I put it on in the lounge while I ate lunch. And they were like, are you an empath? And I was like, ugh. And I actively made that fucking noise. And Mike went, that's how you feel about empaths? I was like, could you tell by my ugh? I'm allergic to empaths. It's an allergy.
Why is this?
It's not that I don't believe it's real, but there is a type of person who comes into a situation and announces, oh, I'm an empath, right?
Yeah.
They're like, obviously you people can't pick up on it because I can pick up on things better than anyone else picks up okay. on things because I'm an empath, but I'm an empath. And it just grinds my fucking gears.
So I had a question related to this.
Yeah, please.
You might not be an empath, but I'm certain you have a gaydar.
A little
How
bit.
How good is your gaydar?
It's not great. It could be better.
Really?
It could be better.
It just goes off the charts whenever I walk in the room.
I'm very open-minded, you know? I'm like, hey, maybe this person just... Actually...
Maybe this person just wraps up clips really well.
Just tell me you're gay. You don't have to let me guess it. You don't have to give me hints all the time and expect my gaydar. I'm just kidding. I don't know. I'm not great at gaydar in real life because I'm very open-minded. And I'm like, just because someone seems gay doesn't necessarily mean that they're gay. So my gaydar is not very good because I'm just too, you know, open-minded. I don't know.
You're an empath. That's what it is.
Kill me. There were a couple things, though, that I noticed about this classic episode that I really liked. One was that they changed the lighting between segments. So they would play a little in between, like the intro for the segment that they still use on The Thing Is. And they would change the lighting color.
Yeah, fun.
I think Shannon would hate that because she likes it a certain way.
Sure. Well.
But yeah. Anyway, I really liked his story about having sex with this girl and finding out that his dad was dead.
I just broke it up with my girlfriend, and my dad was in the hospital very sick. And she wanted to have sex, and I was kind of throwing a party in my basement. And she like walks in the back room, takes all of her clothes off, and I'm a kid, so I'm like,
how much
how
of a kid?
17 or 18.
How old is she?
Same age.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah. And she's like, we should have sex, and I was like, you're right, you know. And she's like, well, let's go upstairs, and I'm like, we could just lock that door and do that right here. My mom's sleeping upstairs, and she's like, no, we should just go up to your room, and I'm like, no, we should really just do that. So we go up to my room because I'm not going to argue, and I start fucking her, and the phone rings, and my mom screams because she found out my father died.
Oh, my God.
So I'm inside of her while I have the feeling and chills up my spine knowing my dad's dead, and now I look at her while I'm still pumping because I don't know what to do, and I go, oh, I think my dad's dead. And then I finished. And
then, I mean, what kind of fetish does this create for you?
It's not a good one. No, but I don't think I finished. I think I just stopped.
Dave
and
has
then
murdered half his family.
We never really talked again after that. Yeah. I think we just knew that had happened, and it was best we avoided each other. From what I understand, she did porn and a lot of designer drugs in Hollywood.
Oh, right.
So, but that would be I guess that'd be a silly date.
So I wanted to know, on that note, what's the weirdest time you've gotten bad news? Like, this is the worst timing ever.
I was in the middle, I don't know if this counts because I didn't really find out until later, but I was in the middle of the worst film shoot of my fucking life at New York Film Academy. Actually, second worst film shoot of my life, worst at New York Film Academy. And I got a call from my dad halfway when I was like booming on fucking Coney Island in the fucking, it was cold. It was probably coming up on 2 years ago. Nightmare. Ugh. He was like, hey, can you talk? And I went, no. And he went, all right, call me back when you can talk. And I got home at like midnight and my uncle died. Like, he was trying to tell me that my uncle died. And I was like, Jesus Christ, as if this day couldn't get any worse.
Oh, you didn't use that as an excuse to get out of work?
I did. I had for some, there was some other reason I had asked for off the next day with that side of the family. And they went, obviously that's canceled, but you still need to be here. So I went, I had already called out.
Mm.
So it's kind of nice to miss that next day because I fucking hated that shoot.
Yeah.
Makes sense. That's the first thing that comes to mind. Do you have a story?
I mean, similar, but it was more like I literally had my friends come in one time and pretend like they were family members, give advice so I could get out of working at McDonald's.
What was the advice? Oh, had died.
Not died necessarily, but like, hey, car crash, we gotta go.
Okay, okay. Did it work?
Yeah.
And then you never got to use that excuse again at McDonald's?
I mean, yeah, but I mean, car crash, it's a pretty, there's a wide range you could still use.
It's true. It's true. But what if another family member did get in a car crash? Then they'd be like,
bad driver.
Really?
They're a bad driver, dude. That's what it is.
Yeah. You're
boy,
like,
oh boy.
You're like, they're like me. They can't really see. So they're really bad at driving. It was fun.
My last thing was just, I thought it was very funny that Corinne petting zooed a ghost.
Oh, yeah. She hold your palm out flat with the fucking lollipop. That was funny.
But we do have clips from this week.
This week, yes. This was a weird no man's land because I was dog sitting, so I drove to work every day. Also, it was the no man's land between Christmas and New Year where no one knows what day it is. What did I do?
Well, let's just start off.
What the thing is?
With,
ding.
You're on Real Ass Podcast a lot. You do three of those.
I sure
shows.
Do. I sure do. I think he's setting up a bit, guys. Guys, I'm scared.
Well,
go get your shit.
On
go get.
Monday, Hannah Rochlin and Brendan Saglo were on.
Yes,
and
they were. Oh,
Lewis, what?
I think I know what we're doing here. This is much less scary than I thought it was going to be.
What? What do you know?
I suspect. Should I guess, or you want to tell me it?
Go ahead, guess.
Are you going to have me taste test sodas?
Let's do a little taste test, because sure. I did a taste test with Diet Coke.
Do you
Coke
like Diet
Zero.
Soda?
No.
I
don't
fucking
like
hate
soda.
Diet Soda. Oh, you
actually
don't drink soda at all?
But I do drink sugar-free Red Bulls, so that counts.
You do drink a lot.
It's
that's
just
a regular.
For the energy, though.
He's got a regular right there.
Yeah,
hold it up.
Reggie, because they were out.
They can't see that.
Oh, speaking of which, so we're going to get into this a little bit more, but I was flying, and I went to get a C4. Because I wanted some kind of different energy drink. I thought it was like weed, where if you mix up your tolerance on different energy drinks, maybe it'll hit you differently and you can get some more energy.
So what happened?
It felt like my blood was melting.
I bet.
It, nightmare.
Nightmare.
I felt like I was literally withdrawing from crack cocaine.
Oh my God.
It was terrible. Never drink C4. But
bring me these fucking diet sodas.
I wanted to see if you can tell the difference.
My brother, go get him. I'll set you up. My brother drinks Diet Coke very regularly. Cannot stand regular. I'm the opposite.
All right, so is
and
this...
I can't even use the Zach method of being like, which one's fizzier, because they've been sitting there for a minute, so now I can't tell.
Yeah, exactly. That's the point.
All right.
All right, so which one
is... So I have to
is...
say which one's diet and which one's zero?
Yeah.
That's like Dr. Pepper. Do you put fucking Dr. Pepper in this? And that's something else. I don't know what that is, but this is Dr. Pepper. Dude, I fucking love Dr. Pepper. Okay, why did you punk me? What happened?
Why did you punk me?
So sorry, walk me through your thought process here. What happened? I'm gonna drink this. I fucking love Dr. Pepper, man.
So I was trying to think of just
clip that
fun ways to integrate this this clip into the show. I was like, it's boring to just do Diet Coke and Coke
Zero.
So
why didn't you tell me? Was the goal to drink this and tell you what it is?
So Jorge and I came up with the idea to just say it was Diet Coke or Coke Zero and then get your reaction when it clearly wasn't. You walked
so
in
if
on
that
us.
Was the goal,
you walked in on us in the middle of our dastardly deed.
You literally could have been like, hey, go in the other room, we're working on something. But you went, no, no, it's ruined, no, no, stop, get out, get out.
We definitely wild
overreacted. Is that what you're going to say? You overreacted?
We wild styled a little bit.
But you did it, and you got a better opening out of me because of it. So it was all worth it in the end, I would say. Okay. And Jorge's not even here to reap the benefits.
Well, that's the bit, folks.
There's the bit. You got exactly what you wanted. If the goal was for me to be like, what the fuck, this is not Diet Coke, then you got exactly what you fucking wanted, man. What's the other one? What is this?
That's Diet Coke.
No, it's not. I know it's not, because I hate Diet Coke, and this is, like, tolerable.
So, on the thing is...
Ding.
They talked about...
Oh, this was with Joanna.
Yeah, they talked about scams.
Sorry.
And getting scammed. I just tried to scam you.
You did just try... Great segue. Can I say... Okay, candidly... when I found out that Joanna was in Lemon Stealing Whores, I was delighted. That is my favorite porn meme of all time. I was delighted. I told everyone. I was like, she was the Lemon Stealing Whore!
This is because you like plots. You love a good plot.
I've never seen it. I can't imagine. It's so funny because I...
You love a good plot. I don't know.
It's so funny because... Harrington was like, what? And I'm like, yeah, Lemon Stealing Whores, like the meme. And he's like, oh, I know it as the porn. And I was like, how could you see that intro and still want to watch porn after that? How do you watch that and go, yep,
I mean, you know what,
still
they,
hard.
You know what they say about laughter?
Ah.
If you can laugh.
I would just be so, it was just.
You can steal lemons.
Yeah.
So Joanna scammed.
Got
candles.
Scammed. Mm-hmm.
So, this was actually not even that. Well, it was probably like 10 years ago at this point. Okay. It was before I met my husband. And before that, I had just gone through this like breakup. And I was walking my dog. And I walked past this psychic. And, you know, outside it said $10, like love reading or whatever, you know. And I was like, I have
$10.
Yeah,
right, you just change.
Think it's
your
a sign. Favorite. Yeah, I'm gonna go on in. I come in, of course. I'm like, can you give me the $10 love reading?
I was not like, you sure you don't want $25 I mean, future reading?
Yeah, yeah.
You don't.
And she was like, all right, sit down. And then she starts pulling out all the cards, and it's all the bad cards. And she was like, you have a love curse on you. Like somebody put a love curse on you. Like, have you ever started to realize that every time you fall for someone, it just, it doesn't work. And I was like, oh my God,
yes.
You're right.
I mean, what a crock of shit.
Yeah. And I was
I
like,
I love
you're
the
right.
scam.
Go yeah. ahead. And then she was like, I was like, what do I have to do to lift the love curse?
$50.
$50 more dollars. No. Maybe we can figure it out.
She said it was going to cost $1,500 for these special candles, okay? These special
they
candles.
They smell like Gwyneth Paltrow vagina.
Yeah.
Make you feel better.
Yeah. And, you know, this was before OnlyFans. $1,500 was much harder to get at that time.
You were a cocktail waitress at Stilettos.
Yeah. No, I was a porn star, okay, but not, you know, it was just different. A more resourceful one back then. Anyway, I mean, $1,500 is still a lot of money, but whatever. And I was like, I have to think about that. And then she's like, do you never want to fall in love again? Like, do you realize, like, there's no way to break this curse unless you get these candles and you say this and this and this. And I was like, she was like really convincing. My dog is like, you know, sitting there.
Well, do that again. Yeah. Zoom in, Mike. Go for it.
And I'm just like, all right, let me think about this. And I had just gotten back from like a feature dance trip where I had a bunch of cash on me in my house. And I went home and I started counting all these singles. And I was like, okay, I have to give this woman $1,500 because I have to break the love curse. Okay. So then I went back and I gave her $1,500 in singles. And she gave me these candles and she like told me I had to like get a picture of the guy that just broke my heart and like say this thing and do this other thing. You know, she's like asking me if I have any of his hair. I'm like, oh, why would I have his hair? You know, but he did leave like some underwear at my house once. So I was like putting it around. I like did like a whole voodoo situation and like, you know, I was like, okay, well I did it. And I gave her the money, and then guess what? He still didn't call. So I called her. Went back to this woman like a week later, and I was like, hey.
Under the candle was TJ Maxx, $4.99.
Yeah.
And
I was like,
oh, shit. And I
was like, bodega. And she was like, hi.
The Jesus candle from the bodega.
Yeah, so she saw me walking my dog, and she just comes outside, okay? And she's like, She's like, oh, I've been thinking about you.
And I was of course, yeah. I was like, because yeah. Con Ed is due.
Like, yeah, listen, we have something to talk about, you know? Like, I did everything you said. He still hasn't called me. and you know, and she's like, no, like, I've been, like, looking into it, and, like, the curse is much stronger than
He's much stronger. Yeah. You need to give me $5,000.
Yeah. She's like, somebody really, like, really put a very strong curse on you.
Essential oils. That's what you need.
And I was like, oh my God.
No, No, you didn't.
She told me I had to give her $2,500 now for her to do some extra work all night, to stay up all night and like do something that could like unlock the curse. And I was like, all right, I have to think about this. And I go back to my house.
Are you counting ones at your house?
I start counting ones again while I'm crying. You guys are gonna think I'm committed when I leave this show.
So have you? I think we've probably talked
have
about this
I
a little
bit.
Have
I ever been scammed into buying candles? No, I haven't.
Well, any scams that you've been a part of?
Scams
you did
I've been a part
get
of.
Scammed at Vegas. There was one.
Oh, that. I don't know if that was a scam per se. I was almost coerced into a timeshare.
Okay. You went to a film academy for your education. There's another one, Sally Mae.
Oh, I didn't go to the film academy. I went to Emerson, which is a real school, but Sally Mae is still a scam. Fuck Sally Mae. If anyone from Sally Mae is watching, all my homies hate Sally Mae. Me and Mike. Fuck Sally Mae. Give me my money back.
I've never really been. Maybe I've been. Have I been scammed? Probably. I mean, I got my account hacked recently. Yes. Okay. So this
I assumed you were going to talk about your hawking on the street days.
No, because we've already talked about that. But recently, I got my bank account hacked almost the same way Lewis did. I just remembered this because I forgot that this is why. So I got a call from someone claiming to be the fraud department at my bank, and they were like, "Yo, someone hacked your shit." I'm like, what? And they were like, you got to text us such and such and such. And I think that was a security code they got to get into my account. And then they wire transfer all my money out, and I still haven't got some of it back.
That sucks, dude. Are you kidding? You still haven't gotten it all?
It was a Zelle transfer that they did.
And you didn't call your bank and go.
I did. Hey, dude. Don't you remember? This was like literally the week before Skankfest. You remember I was flipping the fuck out
of the
studio?
You were flipping out. Yeah. I do remember that. And you still haven't gotten some of that money back.
Some of it. I got some of it back and some didn't. And then got a call from the detective recently about this, but nothing happened.
Nothing happened? Fuck that, dude.
It's fine.
Fun fact for the listeners, your bank will never ask you to tell them a security code.
Yeah, I did not know that.
Yeah, now you know. You had to learn the hard way sometimes. It's okay.
You know what? Only Sally Mae. I'll only give them my security codes from now on. On Berg's base last week, Berg had a fun little segment where he called out Jason Ellis on behalf of Luis J. Gomez.
I will be fighting Jason Ellis.
You're stepping in.
I'm stepping in. I'm simping for Luis J. Gomez. You can't be bullying my boy Luis. Now let me prepare you, Mr. Ellis. I don't need to train because I'm already highly skilled in martial arts. I have a brown belt in Taekwondo. I received that brown belt when I was 16 years of age. Now, many people are going to think, is my skill still up to the snuff that it was at 16 years of age? You don't lose flexibility and knowledge.
It's like riding a bike.
It's like riding a bike. Mm-hmm. So, Jason Ellis, I'm simping for Luis J. Gomez. I'm coming for you.
So, I wanted to know, when was a time that you've stood up for a friend and maybe you shouldn't have?
The problem is that I'm a pussy. So, like, maybe I should defend people more, and I don't. There are times that I should have, you know, no need for apologies, a time I should have apologized but didn't. There are many times that I should have stood up for somebody but didn't.
Really? Mm-hmm. For me, it was, it's more like you have a friend you have to do explaining for.
Yeah.
Like, yeah, I'm friends with them. I trust me, they're cool. I know they're a lot right now, but you just got to get to know them. They're a good person, and that happened a couple of times. Like,
yeah.
They went to a frat party.
Oh, yeah, my girlfriend all the time. Not anymore, but, like, in high school. My girlfriend's very abrasive over text and likes to make these like big group chats where she adds people and then forgets. And then talks, is very abrasive in a way that if you've never met her in real life, you're like, what the, what? Why is she saying that? And I have to be like, no, she's cool. Like, you just got to meet her, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Damn. Yeah, but for me, it was, so I had gone to a friend of mine from back home. He went to a different college than I did, and I went to his, he was in a real fraternity, and so my friend had also decided that he was going to invite a girl that had no interest in him, and bring her along, and I guess she somehow convinced him that they were going to steal one of the frat brothers' beers and drink it, which is like, guys, because it was bring your own beer, but it was like, we did bring our own alcohol, like, what are we doing?
You didn't need to do that. She didn't need to do that.
She was just doing it just to be
trouble.
Yeah, for sure. And then we had to like literally walk up to my friend's like frat brother and be like, yeah, I mean, it was fucked up. Let me buy you another beer or something. Mm. And it got smoothed over. It was definitely one of those situations where I knew he was in the wrong, but I was like, this is my friend.
Sure.
I have to kind of stick up for him a little bit here. Sure. We had to play it very, you know, because he is still a frat brother. Because I didn't, you know, you'd also don't want to be like, hey, you don't want to start a fight and get him in trouble with his own fraternity. Right, right. So yeah, it was a very complicated situation. But that's my story. Speaking of sticking up for friends and not sticking up for people, on Believe You Me, they rallied around the fact that there are some people in the UFC who kind of do things that they're not supposed to in terms of steroids.
Mm-hmm.
And Chito Vera very publicly stated that he thinks taking steroids is cheating.
I really believe Even if USADA randomly tests you, they can only test you from 6 to 6. So if you have money and a decent doctor, I believe people are still cheating until this day. Mm-hmm. I really believe that.
Me too.
I heard there's drugs you can take and literally overnight kind of like disappear. I'm like, you can go for vacation. You can go like USADA is effective, but I'm like, are you sort of testing people in the fucking in a third world country or deep down in fucking, I don't know, Russia? I don't know. I live in fucking California. They come to my house all the time. But I would probably rather die than cheat.
You're more into film and stuff like that. Are there any performance enhancing drugs in film?
Oh, that's such an interesting question. I feel like it's such a cheat code when a film uses a bunch of
ADR.
ADR, yeah. No, but no, honestly the opposite. But like, no, a bunch of ongoing shots, like uncut shots. Like 1918, is that the name of the movie? The one about World War One that was like supposed to look like it was all one shot? Hold on, I think it's 1918. 1917 is the name of the movie. Came out a couple years ago. 2019. But the name of the movie is 1917, and it was shot to look like all one take, and they like hid the cuts in like things, and I feel like they didn't do that because the movie demanded it. They did it to be like, look how much effort we put into making this movie look like it was one take. You have to give us the Oscar now. That to me is like a quote unquote performance enhancing drug.
Sure. And speaking of movies, just real quick, Bronx Johnny was on Spook Show.
Mm-hmm.
And he was already two shows deep, right? And just drunk out of his mind.
Best guest in a while.
What did you
honestly
think?
Honestly, best Spook Show that episode in a while. They were just great. They're the best. Bronx Johnny should be on Spook Show more. I don't know why he's not. Just notes on the episode in general. Yeah. What the fuck did they watch again? I don't remember.
It was a rat. There were rats. There was like a rat that like attacked a man. It was awful.
Oh, the fucking rats. Oh, God, that movie was terrible. I immediately thought of, it's so funny because they brought him into it and Bronx Johnny was like, rat, that's my one fear. It's rats. And this movie's all about rats. And it made me think of, there's, spoiler alert if you care about 1984. That's like a plot in it.
Fuck. I hated that.
Did you? Do you remember the part where he's like,
I hated that.
One of my he's like, my biggest fear is rats.
Can you imagine?
And then that's what they torture him with, because they like are always tapped into like what you're saying. And then when they need to get information out of him, they torture him with rats because they know that that's his biggest fear.
And just putting it
on his face? You know what's up.
Yikes.
Yeah, that fucked me up real bad. But that's immediately what I thought of, and that's Bronx Johnny.
Speaking of Bronx Johnny also, he also was giving Ian some party playing advice. And I want him to play my New Year's next year because I think it would work out a lot better.
Great combo of, oh, yeah, with the movie theaters.
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah, that was great. That was fun. I would love to rent a movie theater. Although
what would
none
you watch?
Of the, what I watch? Fight Club.
Yes.
What would you watch?
Just gay as fuck.
It's so
it's
gay.
It's a gay movie.
It's a gay movie. Fight Club is a gay movie.
Me? Breakfast Club.
Breakfast Club? Yes. Yeah. Should we tell them? Okay, so a couple months ago, we posted us at the gym with Paco and Jorge, and someone replied to my Instagram and goes, The Breakfast Club. And so, tell me how you feel about this. I'm the princess, unfortunately. He's the brain. Jorge is the basket case girl. And Paco is some sort of unfortunate combination of the jock and the rebel. If you disagree,
comment.
Please comment below. But that's what you would watch in your... It's a great movie.
Never seen it.
Oh, it's great.
I've
oh, we should watch it.
Seen all the Disney spoofs.
Ugh. A lot of ugh in this episode. No, we got to watch the real...
I told you, I'm uncultured now.
No, The Real Breakfast Club. That was one of my favorite movies, too. Anyway, what other shows happened last week? Anything left?
Well, the last one was my favorite clip to cut.
Mike Vecchione?
Did you enjoy this clip?
I loved this clip.
So we're in church and it's crowded and the priest always says this thing, every Christmas Eve mass, he goes, this is, he always makes some kind of comment alluding to it's crowded now, but it's never crowded. So I'm watching him and he takes a shot. He makes a joke about the fact that he goes, 4:30 mass is always this crowded. And it's obviously sarcasm. Anyway, I'm sitting there thinking to myself as a performer, and I'm watching another as a public speaker and watching another public speaker him say that, and I'm like, well, everybody's here right now, so my mindset is we're all here right now. If you want everyone here next week, the same numbers, because it's a draw issue at this point, electrify us, like really earn it right now, like go at the crowd, give a hard sermon, like come at us, make it so meaningful it's like I got to come back to this next week, instead of just like going, oh, you guys don't come to church, you don't have any respect. It's like, no, give us the message that brings us back here next week. And you know what, insist on it, be here next week and follow me on Instagram. If I was a priest, I'd have everybody follow me on Instagram, and then I would say my messages on Instagram, and I would be like, you subscribe or you're going to burn in hell. How about that? I would love to have that power as a performer. If I could just say, either come to my show or hell, show or hell, show or hell.
Be here next week is my new energy all of 2023.
Be here next week. Follow me on Instagram or you're going to go to hell.
That's what I'm saying, guys. If you don't follow the Gas Digital accounts on Instagram.
Mike rules. Which Mike am I referring to?
Figure it out. Breakfast Club.
The Breakfast Club, but it's only Mike's.
Yep.
You're still the brain.
Let's go. But yeah, and that was... I don't hate us. I just be here next week. You know what? That's where we're going
to be here next
this.
Week. If you don't subscribe, you're going to hell.
Yeah. So check that out and follow the Gas Digital accounts at Gas Digital. That's Instagram and Twitter.
Gas Digital exclusive on YouTube. That's where you can find these episodes.
Damn straight. That Blind Mike on Instagram. And what do you got to plug?
Natalie DeCicco _edits on Instagram. DECICCO _edits on Instagram. Follow Doped Up Comedy on YouTube. Doped Up Comedy just started a Patreon. If you're a fan of me, you should subscribe to the Patreon. It's not that much.
People say. White girl.
real. They've started saying that.
All right, well, remember to follow those accounts, and we will see you next week, guys. Thank you.
I just fuck your bitch with some Gucci flip flops. I just had some bitches and I made them look like. I just took a piss and I seen codeine coming out. We got purple activists, I thought it was a drought.